Now, would you propose to someone without ever having met them?
Yes.
Well, you would. Desperate times call for desperate measures. Well, that's exactly what's expected of the contestants on the hit Netflix show Love is Blind.
As the new UK version of the show dropped yesterday, we're catching up with the show's Irish hunk. Is he a hunk? Oh, Conor Griffin, hello.
How you doing, lads?
Before we chat to Conor, though, here's a little taster of what viewers can expect.
Gentlemen, hello. Welcome to the experiment that seeks to answer one very simple question. Is love blind?
I rate that.
Ladies, you will choose someone to marry without ever seeing them.
Hi.
Hello.
What do you do?
I'm a funeral director.
Oh,
calm down. I'm not going to embalm you. Nothing wrong with that.
Stop.
Conor Griffin, you're very welcome to 6 o'clock show. Good to see you. Oh my God.
That's spicy.
It's a good sign you're still smiling. Now, I have to ask you, we just saw a clip of the show there. I'm intrigued as to what the experience was like and why a hunk like yourself decided to do it.
It was one of the most unique and insane experiences I think anyone can possibly have. It was absolutely wild. To be honest, like, I was doom scrolling on Hinge, as I'm sure many of us have been there before, and I was approached via the dating app there. And it was like kind of just say yes to the opportunity. Like, I'm a big believer in kind of just rolling with stuff and seeing how it goes, you know, hence being here tonight. So it was just a Hinge conversation, and next thing I'm on a Netflix set. It was absolutely insane, but a brilliant experience. Met some amazing people, and very, very grateful to
what a journey, Conor. And did you ever think you would ever be on a dating show like this?
No, I did not. I had no aspirations to be on television, a dating show, anything like that. But it was just like, say yes to it and see what happens. And yeah, wild, wild experience.
Now, the show itself has been running for 6 seasons on Netflix USA. This is the first one, I think, on Netflix UK. Did you know what to expect? Were you a fan of the show beforehand?
I had binge watched the first season for sure. I loved it. I fell off a little bit after that, but once I found out that I was going on the show, I definitely caught up to see what was going on. But it was like, it seemed like the least toxic dating show on TV. Like, it was
the least toxic. No, okay, the least toxic.
So that was a tick. Yeah, I was like, it seemed like the most healthy kind of welcoming dating show. So yeah, I
went. Was it when you did the experience? Was it healthy?
Genuinely, the people on it were amazing. They were really, really lovely. Like, the vast, vast majority of people were there for the right reasons. They all wanted to get married. You know, there was some controversial characters on it, but far less than I would have expected on a reality TV dating program. So it was as advertised.
Yeah, did you go on it, by the way, wanting to get married?
I did. Yeah,
did
yeah.
You?
Genuinely.
Really?
Yeah. It was when they approached me, I was really kind of feeling that, like, longing for a relationship. I guess a lot of my mates were settling down, and you know, it was just, I suppose, right time, right place.
And Conor, the show is presented by husband and wife team Matt and Emma Willis. Is it true you didn't know who they were when they walked in?
Yeah. There was a lot of excitement. You know, the room was rippling with electricity, and I was kind of standing there a bit bewildered. But later on, they explained to me that Matt was in Busted. Love Busted. Well, at least
your 3000.
Yeah, absolute tune, banger. So that's my limited extent of knowledge on Busted. But yeah.
And Emma is one of the, I would say, from my money, one of the best presenters on British TV. Also one of the most beautiful, and I have to say, having worked there, absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, she
absolutely
is.
Gorgeous person.
They were so friendly, so down to earth, really engaging, and yeah, they just kind of just gave everyone the time of day. You know, they were sound people and seemed very much in love with themselves. So it's good inspiration.
Maybe you just wanted to date her instead.
There was a few crushes on her, no doubt. Yeah.
But a show like that, she's so beautiful. You're like, all the lads are looking at her. Now, obviously, when you signed up and agreed to do the show, you have to keep it secret. You sign NDAs,
yes,
for all these things.
Very
was
scary.
That difficult for you? I mean, because especially when it comes to affairs of the heart and mm-hmm. love, not being able to share that with your family and your friends.
You know, I'd never signed an NDA in my life before. I felt like I was signing away my privacy, my secrecy, all of that sort of stuff. You obviously have to tell a certain group of close people, because otherwise, first of all, you can't run through something like this without any feedback or any soundboarding. So I spoke to my dad, I spoke to my business partner, and I kind of got their opinions on it. And yeah, they were all very, very supportive. So like, yeah, it was after that, like I didn't tell anyone who didn't need to know.
So Connor, how did your family react when they finally got the news, when you finally told them?
My dad's from a different generation, you know, dating shows are not a thing when he was my age. Initially he was skeptical, to be honest. He was kind of questioning, like, why do you want to do this? You know, what are you in this? What's in it for you? And like, once I explained to him that I was looking to meet someone, he kind of came around to the opinion of what a beautiful way to potentially meet your future life partner, you know?
True,
like, what a story.
He's not romantic. He's not romantic. I love that.
He's not romantic.
Did you tell him about all the disastrous dates on Hinge beforehand?
He doesn't want to listen to me at this stage. Yeah.
I have to ask you, so obviously you were actively dating, you had that Hinge experience behind you.
Yeah.
Did you go into this now with clear tactics as to what you were going to do? Did you have a game plan?
My game plan, and I know this is going to sound so cheesy, was just to be as authentic as possible. Because if you're going to match with the right person, you're going to have to kind of, you know, what's the phrase, warts and all, be open. Otherwise, they're going to be attracted to a fake version of you, which is not going to last past the show. And ideally, you're meeting someone that's going to be around for the rest of your life, not just for the period of filming, you know?
So, Connor, how does the show actually work then behind the scenes? Are the cameras actually on you all the time?
Yeah. All the time, right? All the time.
Wow.
Yeah. You do forget. After day two, it was just like hanging out with the lads in the sitting room. Like, it was brilliant crack. Like, everyone was so sound. We were talking, scandalous stuff.
And like, a few little drinkies mixed in as well?
Here and there, you know. But honestly, there's less drinking than you might think. A couple of days, there was a few drinks had and some salacious scandal unfolded. So, yeah, we kind of cut back and made sure to focus on...
Listen, the first four episodes dropped this week.
Yes.
Have you watched them and are you happy?
Yeah, I watched them and I'm very happy. I think that they gave a really accurate representation of the characters. Like, everyone, I said the vast majority of people, very, very, very lovely, really, really nice people. And I don't think that they misrepresented anyone. So, like, I think it was a very honest show by Netflix.
I'm just looking at your fingers there. Is that an engagement ring?
Kelsey, please.
There's nothing on these fingers, unfortunately.
I always get the fingers mixed up.
So, Connor, like, we're watching a clip of it there on air. You're behind a screen for most of it. So how did you actually find dating behind a purple screen?
Once the kind of visual stimulus is removed and you get used to the absolute weirdness of the situation.
I mean, you are talking to a wall.
Yeah, and it looks like an altar, which is the weirdest thing. It's like a purple altar. I don't know. There was some religious subtext to it, but it was actually, like, once you kind of get used to it, you fall really quickly into the rhythm of the dating and you get to be very honest with people because a lot of it's removed.
You have to be, right?
Yeah.
Is it like being on the phone, though?
Yeah.
Like a phone call.
Do you ever find you open up more on a phone call than you might to the person in front of you?
I hate talking on the phone.
Do you?
Yeah, I do.
I do.
Yeah, I'd rather just meet you in person.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah. I love a good phone call.
Okay. Do you want me to leave now?
Love is blind.
So, Connor, what did you actually do then between the takes when the camera wasn't on you, so to speak?
You'd be hanging out with the lads all day, yeah. And the thing is, you really got to know them, so you'd be so invested in their parts as well. So, like, if they were, like, one of the lads gets dumped, you know what I mean? It's awful, awful, awful to be around. But then when they're, like last night when I was watching it, I was standing up, I was shouting at the TV, like, I was watching the World Cup final. I was like, come on! Because, like, you're so invested. I know what happens. I know the outcomes, but I'm still rooting for them, you know what I mean?
Like, so, Connor, like, if you could do any other dating show on TV at the moment, what would you do?
Naked Attraction.
That's very confident.
No, I wouldn't do another dating show, honestly. Okay. It was one was enough. It was a brilliant experience. I wouldn't do another one.
Okay, you don't have to audition right now. You're grand.
You're safe. This is a safe space. Now, listen, obviously, outside of TV, you co-own a health food business.
Yes.
How's all that going for you? And when did you get started with that?
It's going absolutely brilliantly. We set up during COVID with a little caravan, a food truck, and we towed that into place every single day. And then...
There you are. Ireland.
Ah, look at that. So have I.
And that's near Sea Point. Did you go swimming then there?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. A lot of sea swimmers, a lot of walkers. And we just actually opened our first bricks and mortar at the end of March on Drury Street. And that's absolutely flying. So yeah, it's all going very, very well. Thanks for asking, actually.
What was the inspiration behind it?
Well, to be honest, my mum was an entrepreneur and she always worked for herself, and I found her an incredibly inspirational woman. She used to always say, I only answer to myself and the tax man.
And there's mam there, by the way. We had a lovely shot of her.
Oh, no.
Yeah. And I'm sure she's looking down and smiling on you today.
I hope so.
What's your mum's name?
Leslie. Yeah, she's an absolute legend. So,
and she was your inspiration?
Yeah, big time. Absolutely. Yeah, she was an amazing woman, powerful businesswoman, and yeah, I definitely wanted to follow in her footsteps and make her proud. So.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm sure you have. Where next for you then, Connor? Where do you see yourself going down the line?
Roots is really flying at the minute, and I'm really enjoying the work. So I'm sticking with that. I definitely want to travel a little bit more, but like, yeah, stick with Roots and yeah, see how we go.
Will viewers see you back on Hinge? That's what everyone wants to know.
We'll see.
He's on it right now.
We'll see how we go.
All right, I know, but there could be a ring in the mix, right? Anyway, we won't give away anything. Say no more.
Good man in here.
Absolutely. Anyway, you can catch the first four episodes of Love Is Blind UK right now on Netflix.
Up next, as Rashida prepares to race tomorrow evening in Paris, we're sussing out the competition with sports journo Daniel Hussey. We'll see you in three.
All right, open up Hinge there.
Thank you.